Hello and welcome to More Than the Essentials in Mocha AECC with me, Ben Brownlee. And over the next 3 hours, you are going to be learning a number of different techniques about how you tackle some of the standard problems in Mocha. And that means we are going to be adding things, taking things away, and stabilizing things. We're also going to be working on rotoscoping, so how we can make masks around different objects. So the aim is, by the end of the course, you're not going to be better off just at Mocha. You're also going to have learned a few things about After Effects as well. So that means in addition to some core Mocha techniques, we're also going to be finding some interesting After Effects solutions to our problems. Now, we've structured this course as a series of questions, but if you're a new beginner to Mocha EE, I would suggest you go through the course right from beginning to the end. There's a lot of information contained in this course, so you'll probably need at least 2 or 3 times around it to actually get the most out of all that information. But by structuring this as a series of questions, it does mean that when you do have an idea of a problem that you're not quite sure how to handle, you can just jump right back in to the correct area. So let's get started with exercise 1.
And we're going to start off in After Effects, and we have our sample footage already loaded into a comp here, and this is the area that we're going to be tracking later on. So nothing too crazy to begin with. Now, if you've worked with Mocha AE in versions of After Effects before CC 2019, then you're also going to be seeing a new way of getting into Mocha AE. Because previously, what we'd have to do is we would select the footage that we wanted to track, come up to animation, and go track in Mocha. And we can still do it this way. But the interesting thing about the version of Mocha that is now bundled with After Effects is that it is the plugin version of Mocha. So rather than coming in as a separate application as it did previously, it actually just comes in into the effects as a normal filter. And this means that we can apply it to a piece of footage as we would do any other filter. So instead of coming into the animation all the time, I can also come into the effects and come into my Boris Effects Mocha, and there it is, Mocha AECC. Or I can come over to my effects and presets over here, just type in Mocha, and there it is, Mocha AECC. And when we want to do the actual tracking, all we have to do is click on this big Mocha button, and this will launch the Mocha interface directly within After Effects. Now, if you've worked with earlier versions of Mocha, this might seem a little bit different to you because the interface has been focused, so it's only showing us the essential controls that we need to do most of our regular tracking work. And it's in this essentials workspace that we're going to be doing most of the work throughout this course as well. If you've never seen Mocha before, well, this will be a nice surprise for you as well. Because instead of being bombarded with hundreds of new buttons and hundreds of new concepts to digest, you've got this much more sort of straightforward interface where the majority of the interface is actually taken up by the viewer. So if we look at the viewer here, it's got a regular timeline, just as we have in After Effects. And I can scrub through that, scrub the playhead, or I can just hit play and that will just play through for us as well. I hit the stop there and play backwards. Now, just as a warning, at some points in this course, I am going to be using controls that aren't shown in this original bit of the interface, which allow us to do more sort of complex and advanced stuff. And to begin with now, we just need the lightning tool. Now, if we take a look at the toolbar at the top here, we have our save project. So I can click that and save it at any time. I have my pick tool. And if we take a little look in the bottom right-hand corner, you can see this has got a small white arrow in the corner. This means that I can click and hold on this and I'll get another type of pick tool here. So I can choose between the marquee selection and the lasso selection. And wherever we see that little white triangle in the bottom right hand corner, it means we can click on that button and have a choice of what we want to do there. So we have our pick tool, we have our pan tool, so we can just pan around the viewer. We have our magnifying tool, so I can just zoom in and out. Oh, what a handsome fella he is there. Then I have 3 buttons that are going to allow us to do the main body of our work, which is how we draw shapes. So we have our X-spline tool. So I click on that. I can draw 4 points and draw a little shape around that. And I can right click and that will close the shape up for me. I have a square tool. So I can click in there, draw a square somewhere. And I have a circle tool as well, if I want to draw a circle. And as you can see, once I've got a shape drawn and selected, it also has this white bounding box around it, which is our transform box, which means I can transform this up very easily. And we'll be working with this a great deal in the near future. Now, why would we be drawing shapes in the first place? Well, there are two reasons for doing it. The first is to tell Mocha what it is we want to track, and the second is to draw shapes to make masks or roto splines out of these shapes. So for example, if I wanted to rotoscope out the face here, then I could do that with a nice big friendly shape. The next three buttons up here, the surface, the grid, and the align surface, are going to be useful when we actually start our tracking. So for now, I'm just going to leave those untouched. And our final little drop-down menu here is all about choosing what workspace we're working with. So at the moment, I've got the essentials turned on. I could turn us into classic mode, which shows all the buttons we had in the older versions of Mocha to work with. But obviously, they're still here as well. They're just hidden away. And we can have big picture when I want to just focus on the viewer and nothing else. Or roto, which is designed for helping us out when we start doing roto work. But for now, I'm going to stick with essentials, because this is going to show us the stuff that we actually need at this moment. If we come over to our layers control here now, we've got three different layers. Each of these layers is the different shape that we've created. As we'll see in a later exercise, we can have multiple shapes on each layer, but these layer controls also allow us to change the color of the outlines or the fill, and I can change that just by clicking on the swatch here and giving this another color. Let's give this a nice yellow. And let's make this one here a nice green. And our red can turn into magenta. Why not? The layer controls also allow us to lock the layer, to turn on processing on the layer. So this will decide whether these layers are going to get tracked or not. And turn on and off visibility on the layers as well. Just with a little eyeball there. And at the bottom, we can also trash layers or duplicate a layer or create a group like a folder with multiple layers inside it. I'm going to undo this a few times. I can either go to edit undo or just use the universal undo shortcut, which is Control or Command Z. It'll just take us back there. If we pop down a little bit now, we have our essentials tab where we're going to look at our track motion options and how we start tracking these things through. And we also have the surface repeated here. So these do exactly the same things as the buttons at the top of the toolbar. So showing the surface, showing the grid, and aligning that surface up as well. Now, this was just a quick whistle-stop tour to show you the interface. In the next exercise, we're actually going to start tracking some stuff and looking what this area does for us and how we can start to get our first track in. And that will be in exercise 2.